guys, what is up? It's your girl Rachel and Nighttime Mommy Reviews, and today we're going to be reviewing the all-new Ninja Dual Brew Pro Specialty Coffee System. This coffee maker is also a single serve along with a 12 cup drip carafe here. So you can make up to 12 cups of coffee, single serve, and there's various sizes in between. We're going to go over all the features. We're going to do a demo, test a few things out, because this coffee maker is not just an ordinary coffee maker, and you're going to see that in the video. We'll go over the specs and we'll get into all those details. You guys, if you're interested or if you like videos on small kitchen appliances, make sure you hit that subscribe button, because on my channel, when I see there's something new, I buy it, I review it, and I let you guys know what's going on with it. So we're going to review this coffee maker. Let me know in the comments if there's anything you guys want me to test out next, but let's get started. So as always, we get into the specs first. You guys, this Ninja Dual Brew Pro Specialty Coffee System retails for $229.99. Currently, it can be found at Kohl's, but as you know, as things are new, it only is in select places, and then slowly you'll start to see it on Amazon, the Ninja site, and I will have those links once they are there. It's just right now I cannot find it there. So right now it's at Kohl's, and I'll have a link for that in the description box. In terms of the size, we're going to get into that. For the specs, it's 11.22 inches in length, 9.75 inches in width, and then 15.28 inches in height. Now you guys, it does have a 29 inch cord. It's also max wattage or output is 1550 watts. Let me get into the specs for you guys, because the size will change. So let me show you something. Now on the side here, we have a 60 inch reservoir that you can use, but you guys, this is the cool thing about the system. Oh, really quick, it's a two prong cord, so not three ground, not there's no ground prong. So this tank can be located to the back to make it longer, or you can have it on the side to make it wider if you don't have that much room in the back. So to do that, you just remove the reservoir, and there's a little clip on the back. Let me see if I can lower that for you guys. I'm gonna zoom in. Okay, so there's a little clip. You can kind of see the little, it pulls out a little bit. You pull this off, and you can slide this into place. Once you slide it into place, you have to put this clip back. It looks like it blurred out, so I'm going to go over this again. Once you have the tank in or the back where you want it, now you can add the clip with the part that sticks out. You're gonna just push this into place until you hear the click. Once you hear the click, it's ready to go, and you can add your tank to the back. And now we can, oh, there's a little notch on the back, so you gotta just make sure you notch, you put that on the notch. And now your system is a very thin coffee maker. So let's get into what's included. You have your carafe here. You also have the Ninja Smart Scoop, which also tells you how many scoops you'll need. And you have the smaller cup sizes right here, along with the larger cup sizes, or for the craft. You also get their attachment for their frother, which goes on the side of the unit. There's a little pull out. You just twist it into place and your frother is ready to go. And you just hold the power button to froth when you're ready. Now the frother does not heat. I do want to let you guys know that the frother does not heat your milk. What you have to do is put it in the microwave for about 30 to 45 seconds, and then you can froth. Now you also get a couple of filters for the Ninja system. They're paper filters, I believe. You get your quick start guide, and then the manual, which I've already gone over, and I'm going to let you guys know all the key features, the key points, and the things that I think that really matter for the Ninja. So I'm going to go over all of those things with you guys, but let's get started into the features. So one of the things that I really love about Ninja is that they make sure to find a space for everything. So the Smart Scoop there is kind of like a magnetic place for it, so it'll just stick or click right in place. Frother as well, so frother, even though it comes separate when you get it in the box, you can fold it into place and tuck it right into the system. So I love that. They also, when you want to use, whether you want to use grounds or the K-cups, let me go ahead and lift this up. This is where you would put your K-cups, but let me raise the camera so that you guys can see this. Now, as you can see right now, let me show you. It is currently in the locked position. You can pull it towards you to lock it. You can push it back to unlock it and remove. That's how simple it is. And then here is where you have this little handle, this attachment to add the coffee filter. Here's where you can add your filter, add your coffee, and once you have your coffee in there, you slide it forward for the grounds, and the display will show up that allows you the option to add your grounds. When you start off, you are brought to this main display. What I love about it is that it's touchscreen. So you have 6 ounces, and this is the K-cup option first, 8 ounces, 10, and 12. And you notice that it is on the K-cup. Here is where you can set the time. If you select hour and minutes, you just press the button and then turn the dial as you need and press it when you're ready. You can select your brew style of classic, rich, which will basically use a higher heat to give you that rich flavor. If you want iced coffee, you can do over ice. And then specialty is a stronger coffee, and you have 4 ounces. You can also select delay, where you can delay up to 24 hours in advance. So right here, let's say I wanted to do 8 a.m. tomorrow and I wanted classic, you can select your brew style. So I'm gonna stick to classic. I can select the time that I want, let's say 8:05 a.m., just as an example. Then you select the ounces, and it's ready to go. The display will stay on, letting you know that there's a delay or a delayed brew set up currently. So it will stay on the entire time. If you wanna cancel it, you just click delay, and you're ready. Now, if you wanna use the grounds, there is a, if you press this right here where it says lift to open, this is where you would use the K-cups. If you push it back, you're allowed to remove the little attachment. Let me zoom out so you guys can see. You can remove it. Okay, so right here is where you would add your grounds. There's a little adapter. You put your filter in, and then once you're ready, you slide this forward for grounds. And as you see, the settings appear for grounds. So you don't have to keep that K-cup adapter in there. You can keep it on the side if you primarily want to use this for grounds. And here is where you can change your settings. You have 8 ounces, 10 ounces, 12, 15, 18, and now is where we get into the carafe of 28 ounces, 37, and 46 and 55 ounces. Okay, now you can select, you can also select your brew style of classic, rich, over ice, or specialty. You can turn on the keep warm, which is a warmer plate at the bottom. I'll show you guys that. Keep warm will go up to 4 hours. And here is where you'll know whether the drip thing is closed. It will also beep. So if it's closed and you wanted to select a setting, it will beep and it will flash to let you know, hey, it's closed. You need to turn it, you need to open the valve here. So I opened it and then you can click start. You also have the delay option. You can set your delay. There is a clean option. We're gonna go over the clean as well. Now on the display, you may notice that there is a clean cycle right here in the bottom right hand corner. If you click the clean cycle, it's going to run through the reservoir the entire tank of 60 ounces. This is no ordinary clean cycle. This is meant to descale your coffee maker. It takes 75 minutes because it's going to run through the cleaning solution, through the reservoir, and slowly push it through so it cleans out everything thoroughly. Now, an orange icon will appear if you choose not to do so for a while. Let's say you choose not to do it on, you know, your timing, whether you use it daily or more than a couple times a day. Your ninja will let you know when it's time to clean it with an orange icon. And if you ignore the orange icon, it may stop you mid-brew and pop up the word clean. And it's really CLN on the display to let you know, hey, you need to clean the clean the machine. Now, cleaning the cycle or cleaning the machine can be used with, you can use white vinegar, or you can use a cleaning solution that is meant to clean coffee makers. Now, I say that because that's what they write in here. They write that you can use a descaling solution. Let's see if I can. You can use a descaling solution specifically formulated for coffee maker cleaning, or you can fill the water line with white vinegar. So you can only use white vinegar. Now, the tank does have markings on the side to let you know the cup, the travel, the half a carafe, 3/4 of the carafe, and the full carafe. All right, so before you make your first brew, for obvious reasons, you're gonna wanna clean your tank, and this lid is removable here. So I just filled it to half a carafe because we're going to be using the singles for right now. I wanted to show you guys a couple things. Here you can place, this is just a regular 10-ounce cup. You can also place it on the stand. Now, let's say you want to use a travel mug. I have here a 12-ounce travel mug that you can place right there, so it fits perfectly. You can also use a 16-ounce. And there's even a travel thermos size or a larger thermos size that you can use up to XL. I don't have that. This is just a regular glass for, let's say, iced coffee. Let me see, just out of curiosity, I have a 36-ounce. See, this is a 36-ounce hydro flask. That does not fit. Too tall. But, just to see. To get started, I have here a K-cup. Now, let me lock it into place here. With the K-cup, you lift the lid here to open it. It has three streams or three holes that it's going to puncture through the K-cup. And that's a multi-stream technology that's going to allow it to evenly distribute the hot water into the K-cup to give you a more rich classic flavor. I'm going to use a little stand here because I'm going to use a little cup. So you're going to place that there. I'm going to change the brew style to classic. Now, classic is meant for hot, flavorful, and never really bitter coffee. At least that's what they advertise. For the rich flavor, it says for richer, more intense flavor than classic. And then obviously for iced coffee, you want that authentic flavor that's never watered down. The specialty brew is meant for a brew coffee house style drink with like lattes, cappuccinos, or macchiatos. All right, so I'm going to choose rich, and for rich you have 8 ounces, 9 ounces, 11 ounces. This is a 10 ounce cup, so I'm actually going to go with 8 ounces. It's very quiet, but it is working. You can it's very quiet, but you can hear it just a little bit. You also want to make sure that the chute is open. If it's not, it will beep and let you know. And if you're curious about the temperature, I'll check that as well. Because I did get comments on the last coffee maker I reviewed. So, I'll check. Oh, and that's kind of cool. It has indicator lights letting you know when it's finished. So right now it's almost done. I don't know if you see it flashing, but the lines are getting more solid. Thank you. Okay, so for Rich, we're at 164.5 degrees Fahrenheit. It's really hot for coffee. That's perfect. And I'm going to let it cool off, and then we'll do the taste test with that. Now, I want to do the frothing of the milk. Now, I'm just going to do cold milk just as a demonstration, but all you have to do is just place your milk. You have to submerge the frother just a little bit below the surface of the milk and hold the power button until it reaches your desired consistency. Typically, cold milk will froth more than hot milk. And then you can remove. And you can take this to the sink and hand wash it if you wanted to. I want to show you guys. Let's see if it's cooled down. Okay. Even with the milk, it made it very strong. So if you like strong coffee, at least for my taste, that is very strong coffee. And you guys, I have to tell you, this is my favorite K-cup. If you're looking for a K-cup and you're okay with K-cups, the Colombian Select Medium Roast Coffee is my favorite. But it made it very, very strong. So I typically have this every single day. And the Rich coffee, even with the milk, was very, very strong for me. So I'm going to try Classic just to see if that gives me the outcome that I typically use. So let me clean this up and get it ready. So I reset it. You want to make sure you snap that into place. Turn it on here. I'm going to do Classic here. Select 8 ounces to keep it consistent. You'll see the status icons lighting up. And we'll come back when it's finished. All right, I want to take the temperature just so you guys see what Classic does with an 8 ounce cup. I'm making sure I'm in the center of the cup. It's at 169 degrees just about, or 168.8 degrees Fahrenheit. It's nice and hot. Again, I'm going to let it cool off. And then I will do the taste test there for that cup. Now I'm going to prep a ice cup of coffee because I want to see how this machine does with iced coffee. So I'm just going to place my cup right here. Make sure I snap that into place. And I'm going to do 8 ounces. And it says for iced coffee, you want to make sure that the cup is full of ice. That's exactly what I did there. Once we do the K-cups, I'll also show you that you can do single serve cups of coffee with the grounds as well. So that'll be next. Okay, so the cycle just finished and you can see that the cup of ice, or the cup, is still full of ice. So it looks like it does cool down the temperature. The cup does not feel hot to touch. It actually is a really good temperature. I'm going to just stick that in there. See if I can get the temperature. I'm trying not to touch the ice. 63 degrees. That's actually not bad. And I'm going to add some creamer here. And add milk. See if I can get a straw here. Can't find one. Okay, but it is nice and cold, you guys. That's a really good cup of coffee, iced coffee there. I'm going to save that. Now I did add creamer to the second cup that I did of Classic, and I'm just going to test this out. Okay. Classic is the way that I use, or that I make my coffee, which is just the regular way. You know, I use a regular coffee maker to make my K-Cup. So Rich definitely did change the flavor in the coffee. Definitely. So now I'm going to switch it to the grounds, and I do have a different blend here. So I want to show you that you can use both. You can definitely use grounds, or if you like K-Cups, whatever your preference is. That is why I love the Ninja, because whether you're using this as in an office setting, you can use this mainly for the carafe, or you know, the entire family, or you can use single mode, which allows you to make a single cup of coffee every morning. You can delay it. There's so many things that you can do with this. Now with this test, I'm just going to do classic at 8 ounces. We already know that Rich will give you a stronger flavor. At least I tested it out and it gives you a stronger flavor. So for the purpose of this video, I just want to show you that you can do individual cups with the grounds and K-Cups. So it's not only K-Cups that you can do individual cups. You don't have to worry about it going through the entire reservoir when you want to make one single cup. So you can fill your reservoir for the entire week and use that reservoir of water throughout the entire week without having to refill it. That's convenience right there. So we'll let it run through. We'll be back. All right, so this is over. I'm going to just take the temperature so that we see what the temperature of the coffee is with grounds, to see if it's similar output to the K-Cups. And this is just classic. For classic, it came out at 159 degrees Fahrenheit. Looks like 158.9. I'm lifting it up, but it was at 158.9, and it's just slowly going down as it, you know, it sits longer. So that is with classic carafe. You can also make a good cup of coffee, or a bunch of cups of coffee here. With the carafe, I want to zoom out a bit. With the carafe, there's a little attachment to the lid. I want to show you guys, there is an icon right here, an arrow that needs to be pointing towards the front of the actual carafe. So you kind of just twist it to the left to make it loose and remove it for easy cleaning. And then you place it back in here and turn it to the right. It's ready to go. So I'm going to put that on the side. I want to just show you guys, like, iced coffee, there's still a bunch of ice in there, and I'm drinking it and it just gets better with time. So I want to show you guys the hot water feature next. So say you want to make tea, or say you want to make a good cup of hot chocolate. With the packets, you typically need 8 ounces of hot water. So right here, there's a little notch on the left hand side. It's on coffee grounds. If you turn it towards you, you see you have two options. You can use, let me zoom in here, hot water or boiling hot water. You can set a delay as well. You have between 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, basically 2 ounce increments here, all the way up to 60 ounces. So right here is where it jumps. So you have 60, 50, 40, 32, and then back to the 2 ounce increments here. So because we need 8 ounces of hot water for our hot cocoa, and it's a separate hot water line, so you're not going to get the taste of coffee in your hot cocoa. And just like that, we have our cup of hot cocoa. Now I'm going to mix and get all of the contents nice and mixed. Temperature here, and it's just building. I did not choose boiling hot water, or I think I did choose boiling. Did I choose boiling? We'll check right now. 173 degrees. So in the last clip, I did use boiling hot water in an effort to show you what the temperature is for just regular hot water. I'm going to run a cycle with the 8 ounces using the hot temperature. So the cycle just ended, and using hot water, just a regular hot water, looks like we're at 160 degrees Fahrenheit. So that's not bad. And now I want to show you that, as you can see, you can use hot water for a range of, you know, there's a variety of things. You can use it for hot chocolate. You can even use it for oatmeal, you guys. So do you see how convenient that this bowl fits right on the stand? I want to pull this out real quick so you can see. I have the bowl. This is a regular size bowl. You can also place it on the main plate, where you can place it on the stand so it's closer to the water. And I'm going to add oatmeal to show you, just there's so many things that you can do with it. Now, using the boiling hot water, and I'm just using regular 1 minute oats, quick 1 minute oats from Quaker Oats. They have, it says 1/2 cup of oats, and then also 1 cup of water. So I'm just going to use 8 ounces. All right, so I added my water, and I'm going to stir and allow that to sit. And now, while that's sitting, you can still see, look at how much ice there is in my iced coffee there. I'm drinking it as we go. This is also cool. I'm gonna remove this. But you guys, a soup, a little instant soup, even the cup of noodles if you wanted to. So I'm going to increase it to 16 ounces. And I'm using a fairly large bowl here, just because we're using the other one for oatmeal. All right, so the soup, it's really hot, you guys. But the pasta is softening right now, or the noodles are softening. So while that's softening, I want to show you guys, while that was going, the oatmeal is ready to go. So just add your toppings, and you have oatmeal. You guys, we did this all with the coffee maker. The coffee maker allowed us to make iced coffee, which the ice is still there, and I'm finishing as we do all of this stuff. You have a frother. You have the option to, you know, use the boiling hot water to make soup and oatmeal and coffee and do stronger coffees, cappuccinos, you name it. This machine is changing the game. So I personally can say I like it. I love exactly what they're doing with this. Ninja, they're changing it all, you know. So my personal review, it's worth the buy. I know Ninja has promotional sales. And again, I'm going to have the links for these items in the description box. So if you like this video, or if there's anything you want me to test out, let me know in the comments below what you guys think. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments as well. I'll do my best to get back to them as soon as possible and answer all of your questions. Our soup is almost ready to go. So I say a couple more minutes and you have lunch. Like I said, this can be in your office. And yeah, boiling water at your disposal. Tank is easy to clean. Everything is removable and clean and easy to clean. So I love that. But let me know in the comments what you guys think. What do you guys think about this machine? All right, but until next time, you guys have a great night.